that's why we won't be flying quadcopters today.
Well, as you can see, raining again. So, today's going to be kind of like a grab bag Friday, Saturday. We're upgrading the motors on Red 1. These are Sunny Sky. They're 700 kV, which means they lift a little bit more than what normally Red 1 could do, because surprisingly, Red 1 is like 5 pounds. What a fatty, I know. But I was not aware that it weighed 5 pounds once you put the battery on there. I thought he was a little bit lighter. So, to get him ready for his new motors, we had to buy some things, which included some bullet connectors. And of course, the motor. So you notice they're red, because I have a sense of fashion when it comes to my quadcopters. Red? Okay. So, when I started to think about doing this, I realized I suck at soldering. So these I got for about $36 each at the place I always buy my stuff, is Buddy RC. Not an endorsement, just saying that's where I got it. And these are some of the finest motors out there. Now, sooner or later, I will make use of these, because what that does is just put the flat thing on there and it's less weight, but I'm not worried about it right now. We will be using this little red tip again, which connects to the top of this motor, but we'll do that later. So, when I realized that I had to go do this, you're still a little short for some reason. Why are you short? Hang on a second. All right, I fixed you. You're welcome. Anyway, when I realized how much I hate soldering, I realized I just don't have the equipment to solder. So what we have to do is we have to put these bullet connectors on these wires. Although shorter, we'll probably clip this about here, because that's a lot of extra weight you don't want. I made that mistake with the other motors that are on Red 1 now. I think I wired the wires all the way up and all the way back down around again. I think I did that. Oh no, they're short. I can't remember them having longer wires. So what I'm going to do is show you how to use this little thing. It is a helping hand with a magnifying glass. Kind of looks like something a pot dealer would have, drug dealer, but let's open it up. So I saw this because I was looking into some other videos and I thought, wow, that's a pretty handy thing to have. And I said, I must get one. So I got it on Amazon and they called it an add-on item. So you had to buy something else. You position this thing in a way that helps you hold whatever you're doing. Because I don't know if you ever soldered before, but it takes a lot of hands to solder. So you see, you can hold it up or you can hold it sideways. It looks like some crazy robot guy, and then you get this thing in here and you put it down like that and you're like, I'm a scientist. Yeah. Now I'm gonna go through one solder. I'm not gonna put you through all the other ones because I have to solder 12 things. But I will show you how this is used. So you hook a wire up to it like that, or you can do something like this. Let me spin it that way. And then when you're soldering, you have both your hands free. Now, if I remember correctly, this thing was about $5 or $6. I'll put the real price in the description bar. But $5 or $6, and it really is heavy. This base is very heavy, so it'll stand. Not on my hand, of course, but on a table it'll stand. When you're soldering, you see you have your hands free to do this, which would be the gun and the solder. Now, in order to get this, I had to buy something, and I said, well, what the heck, I'll get that. Because that was pretty cheap, too. It was, I wanted to say it was like $20, $29 on Amazon, and they delivered it next day. So, you know, that's a win. Now, one of the reasons I thought this would be halfway interesting is that I learned along the way there are different types of flux. What's flux? I had to Google it. It's just a material that helps solder stick better. And I almost made the mistake of getting the wrong flux. And the wrong flux is the stuff that's used for plumbing. That will corrode wires, as I understand it. And you don't want to go corroding that when it's inside your ESC, because, you know, that's crash city, baby. So, what you want to look for is rosin flux. That's electrical. And I have that coming tomorrow, but I'm not going to wait for these motors, because these generally, I think I have rosin solder anyway, which is the other way you can get around getting it. So, That said, let's get to the next grab bag Saturday we're doing today. So remember last time I flew, I said I had forgotten to modify something, and that was this head thing that I wear. And what I had to do was there were a couple prongs on here, and I had to cut one piece off of this. The reason I'm doing this is so when I do product reviews again, I can do this.
I don't mind telling you, I kind of feel like a unicorn with this on.
Except I think the unicorn horn goes that way. Age, people. It's just age. So now I can do this. So this is a gimbal, and you see I have it kind of hooked up this way. And what I'll be able to do is look at the quad and get steady shots when I'm going around quads, if I'm doing product reviews, I'm getting certain views of it that I want to see. I know, it looks kind of weird, but it works. All right, so I took the silly thing off my head. I will use it for soldering. I'm not going to put you people through soldering. I just wanted to show you a couple things, especially this. I had a Weller, which you get over like Home Depot or Walmart. And it was okay. This one happens to be a little bit more powerful. And it's adjustable. And it'll probably make soldering a heck of a lot easier. Not to mention having this thing. So a short little video just to let you know I am still alive. Nothing happened to me since you saw me last weekend playing around with fish. And I have devised a couple Mad Cat, Mad Hatter devices. We do have Comic-Con coming up next weekend, so we'll have plenty of use for this. I talked to GoPro, and we came to a conclusion that the GoPro 4, which this is not, is really only good when temperatures below 80 degrees. And I don't think they had Florida in mind when they designed it. So we will be using the GoPro 4 inside Tampa Bay Comic-Con to get some really nice shots, and we'll use this. I'll probably use this just sparingly. I'd like to walk around and get some nice walking shots with head turning shots, because I think that'll be fun. Sure, certainly better than last year's videos, because I really would like to get some nice smooth stuff this time, because the costumes are so good. There you go. I'm gonna get the soldering and eating some dinner, and then I will show you the results in a little while after I'm done. But I'm not gonna make you sit through all 12 of them, because I'm sure that would be really exciting to tears. Mighty Thor from someone's apartment, again, on a rainy day, in somewhere in an undisclosed location in the great city of Tampa, Florida. Sleep!